Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. This episode will be the first in a short series that covers character animation. There are a ton of ways to create characters using a multitude of both free and purchased plugins, so keep in mind that this is just one method that I found useful. In this episode, we will create the head of our character using shape layers. In the next episode, we will create the body, and following that, I will show you how to quickly rig the character by parenting layers and using null objects. I always use plugins that are either native to AE or ones that are free. So after that, I'd like to show you how to rig this character using DUIK. It's a free plugin and it's very powerful. This will give you some options for how to rig your own character. There's a lot to get through, and I'll try my best to keep it at 7 minutes, but we may go over for this series of tutorials. Let's get to it. Okay, so in this episode, we're going to create the head of our character. But before we do that, I have an episode where we created a color controller, and we're going to do that again for this series of tutorials. It will save you a ton of time later on in case you want to change the look of your character. So let's go to Composition and choose New Composition, and we'll call this Color Controller. And we want to add an adjustment layer, go into our effects for expression controls, and use color controller. So let's start with the first control and call it skin, and let's duplicate that, and we'll call this skin highlight. Let's duplicate skin highlight, call this hair, eyes, shirt, shirt highlight, pants, pants highlight, and shoes. So for skin, let's go for something maybe a little peachish. And for a skin highlight, let's copy that, but then we want to make this color a little bit darker. For hair, we'll just go with black for now. Eyes, we'll go for black for now. Shirt, let's just make it maybe a blue. And for shirt highlight, we'll copy that shirt color and again darken this a little bit. For pants, we'll go like a khaki kind of look. And for pants highlight, we'll copy that and make this a little darker. For shoes, we'll just do a white. And in order to keep these options open, lock down your effects control for this adjustment layer. Now, I've already created this comp. As you can see, it's just 1920 1080, and I gave it a name. I'd like to change my background so it's not black, because I have some black in this character. So if you go to Composition and go to Composition Settings, you can change the background to whatever you want. So right click, choose New Shape Layer, and we'll call this Head. And in this layer, we want to add a group, call this Face, and let's add an ellipse and a fill. If you hold down the Option button and click Color, you can pick whip your skin color right up here. And as you see, it changed to the skin color we've chosen. Now, say you want to have multiple characters, you want them to be of different ethnicities. Changes make it darker and it updates automatically. If we unlink our size for the ellipse path, make this face shaped. Okay, so now we want to add a beard. So let's take this face layer and duplicate that. And we're going to call this beard. And we want the color to be our hair color. So Option click. And we want the beard to fit our character's face properly. So the way we do that is we take this ellipse path under our beard layer, duplicate it. Then with the beard layer highlighted, add a merge path. It's going to allow us to use this ellipse path 2 as a mat. Choose for our mode, subtract. And now watch as we start to move this up and down. Let's add another group, call this mustache. And we move to the top above our beard layer. And let's just add an ellipse and add a fill. And again, we want to make that fill our hair color, and let's just kind of resize this a little bit. Actually, we should call this layer face. So let's add one more group. We'll call this teeth, actually. Move it above our mustache layer. Let's add an ellipse and a fill. Let's just set this fill to white because it's our teeth. Pull this down to where it should be. Resize up a little bit. In our teeth layer, let's add a rectangle and make sure it's wide enough. With teeth highlighted, add merge path. We want to set it to subtract, and then we're going to use the rectangle to set our mouth. And then we just move our teeth layer up. Let's add a new shape layer, left eye. So I'm going to call his left eye the area that's going to be over here to our left. Add an ellipse and a fill. And we have our eye color here, so we want to Option click and choose the eye color. And then let's just place the eye where it should be. And let's duplicate our left eye, rename it right eye, and then just move the eye over. Okay, now one of the things I like to do is to make their eyes blink. There's a very easy way to do that. I've got this composition set to a really long distance. Let's set it to about 15 seconds. If you click in and then right click and trim comp to work area, go to about 1 second in, unlink our scale option here for the right eye, make a keyframe, page down twice, 1, 2, and let's set the Y to 0, 1, 2, and set it back to 100. And then let's go to about, let's say 4 seconds. Copy and paste that last keyframe. If we option click or alt click if you're on PC or scale, click this little arrow here. We want to go to property, loop out cycle. It loops these keyframes we have. Click on scale and copy and come down to our scale for our left eye, paste. And it brings over the expression with it. So now this character will blink indefinitely no matter what the character is doing otherwise. Right click, new shape layer. We're going to make some ears, left ear. And we just want to move this down to the bottom. And we want to add an ellipse. And we want to add fill. And for this fill, we're going to option click, go to our skin, place the ear where it needs to be, add a group. And let's put this ellipse in this fill inside of that group. And we'll call this outer ear. And if we duplicate that, call this inner ear. We can change our fill to the skin highlight color and then just reduce the size. Let's duplicate left ear, rename it right ear, open our position and move it right on over. Add another shape layer, call it nose. Let's add a rectangle and a fill. And for this fill, we want to grab our skin highlight. Okay, let's make sure it's above our face layer. Increase our roundness on this, then unlink our size for the rectangle path and just kind of play with whatever size you really want his nose to look like. Let's keep going. Let's add a new shape layer. Let's give him some glasses. And actually, let's go ahead and add this to our color control. So highlight shoes, and let's just name this glasses. Maybe we can even make it like a dark green. Okay, so for in our glasses, let's add an ellipse, and we're just going to add a stroke. And we're going to make this stroke color our glasses. So let's use the ellipse path positioning. And we just want to go negative 100, and that'll put it right on top of our eye. And move it up and just kind of play with the settings here. Let's use a rectangle instead. Negative 100, play with our stroke width a little bit. Increase the size. Now we can kind of round out the edges. Okay, and let's duplicate that rectangle path and make this one 100, so it covers his right eye. Then let's add another rectangle. Set the size to 60 and 7, something like that. Just enough to make the bridge. Let's group these together because I have an idea of something to do here. So we'll take the first rectangle path, put in our group, add another group for our second rectangle path, and another group for our third. Group 3 is the right eye. Group 2 is the left, and group 1 is the bridge. Now with our stroke set underneath all of these, whatever we choose for a stroke will change the color of every aspect of our glasses. However, you may want to put some lenses in there. And the best way to do that, let's duplicate this stroke twice and just drag them into each one of these groups so that way they have their own stroke. Then let's go into our left group here. We're going to add a fill, make that white. And let's lower the opacity to about 35%. And now see how it kind of overlaps here. It doesn't look right. All you have to do is move the stroke on top of the fill to put it behind. And we'll do the same thing for the right side. Just want to add a fill, make it white, down to 35%. Be sure you put the fill underneath the stroke. And yeah, now let's move our nose above our glasses. Okay, so the last thing we need to do now is to add in the eyebrows. So let's right click, choose a new shape layer, call this left eyebrow, and then we need to add a rectangle and add a fill. And we want to option or alt click color and choose hair. And then inside of our rectangle path, let's use the position settings in here and change this to negative 100. So it's lined up with our eye in this part of the glasses. And then we'll just move that above. And let's unlink our size settings for the rectangle path and just kind of play with these settings a little bit, make it short and wide. And now if we increase the roundness, it's more of an eyebrow look. And let's duplicate left eyebrow, name it right eyebrow. Let's open this up and under the rectangle path settings, change this negative 100 to 100. So it's lined up above our eye. And there is our guy so far. So now you can add in hair if you'd like. You can do a number of things. You can give him a hat if you want to make him where he can talk. There are a few other things that you can do for the mouth, and I can even touch on some of those tricks. Just kind of give you an idea about this color control also, just real quick, like with our glasses here. If you choose any color, it's going to update automatically, and so it's just so much easier to have this color control. The same goes for skin, so you'll make them darker, and you know, you want to make the highlights darker. You can do all kinds of things instantaneously. So that's it for this episode. In the next episode, we will be creating the body of our character, so make sure to stay tuned. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thanks, everybody. We'll see you next time.